In this video, I'm going to show you four different ways to loop over objects in JavaScript. Feel free to jump to whichever loop you're interested in by using the chapters in the description below. Number one, for in. Head into the browser. I'm using the Chrome browser here to write our JavaScript in the console tab. And what we're gonna do now is we're gonna create an object, okay? We're gonna use this for all of the different loops. So we're creating a constant variable student and we're saving an object in it. Remember, an object always is made up of keys and values. In this case, keys are students, valents are their scores. We're just gonna fast forward quickly. Don't forget to comma separate the separate values. So now we're starting with the for loop. By the way, instead of key, you'll also see sometimes properties. So we're saying for key in students, we are now logging out to the console. So we want to log out every single line to the console. Make sure to use backticks, okay? Those are not single quotation marks. This is so that we can use string interpolation. And then we're logging out whatever is in key and we're using the bracket notation to get the values. So students and then bracket key. And that will give us a score. You hit enter and there you go. When you use the for in loop, there might be a problem. You see, for in also loops over the properties of its prototype. Now, if you don't know what prototype is, just think of the prototype being the parent and the actual object being the child. So the child can inherit certain properties that are part of the parent or of the prototype. And that is what you're seeing right here in this example. So the student's proto, this is what I use to make the property from the prototype also be part of the object. And that's why you see the output. At the very end, we see the test colon zero. How do you deal with this? Well, you need to add something extra to your for in loop. After we open up our for loop, we're saying if students, and then we're using the method has own property and we're passing the key, then log it out. And that's why we don't see test here. So that is very important that if you use the for in method and you're not quite sure if this object maybe has a prototype, in that case, make sure to use has own property, else you might see properties there that you didn't expect. Now, this was the original way to loop over objects and it's still valid. You can still use it. But with ES6 and ES8, so the newer versions of JavaScript, newer ways have been introduced to loop over objects, and that's what we're going to look at now. Number two, keys method. The keys method gives you back an array containing the keys or the properties of your object. So that's what we're going to do now. In all students, we're going to say, okay, give me back object keys, and we're going to pass in the students, our object. So that's going to give us back an array containing the names, so the keys of the students, as we can see here. And now we're gonna use the for each method to loop over this array. By the way, I'll be linking the for each detailed video right about now. So we can just say log out to the console. And again, we're using backticks here to be able to use string interpolation. And now we're just saying log out whatever is in name, as that will be the key or the property on every current loop. Close that out and curly bracket, and we hit enter, and then we'll see all names. By the way, we can also use this keys method to log out the scores, so it is the values. So we're gonna use the bracket notation to do this on this iteration. I just went ahead and cleared the browser in case you wanna do that too. There you go. So now it, oh no, actually, this is autocomplete. This is a funny thing that happened. It just gave me the for each method from before, so I had to delete this. And now we're gonna do the same thing with name, but this time we're gonna use the bracket notation to get access to the scores. So it's going to be students and then name, and then let's close that out. And now you'll see that we have access to the key. So the name and the value, which is the score, once we hit enter. Not too bad. Number 3, values method. Again, I cleared the browser and I'm guessing that you can guess this. The values method will give you back all of the values of the object. And again, it's going to be an array, which means that we can loop over it. So we use the values method on the object and pass in our object. And again, my favorite way of looping over an array, just use the for each. And we're using score here to access the different scores on each loop. I'm just going to log out the scores and you'll see a bunch of numbers. There you go. Number 4, entries method. This time around, we're going to use the object.entries and pass in our object, and that will give us both the keys and the values. And you're going to notice that it's going to be a two-dimensional array. So again, it being an array, we're going to use the for each method to loop over it. That's what we're doing here. We're using the student scores, and as you can see, we have an array containing arrays. So we use the for each, and by the way, you can also use for each with arrow notation or arrow functions. In this case, I'm using the traditional way. Again, we're going to log out to the console, and we want to log out the key and the value, so the student name and the student score. Again, be aware, these are backticks, otherwise the string interpolation would not work. So obviously, we want to log out student, we want to log out score. And it's going to do something that is going to be very interesting and might be a bit unexpected, because the output is not what we wanted. Something's off here. How can we rectify this? Well, we need to use what is called the destructuring assignment in JavaScript. That's what I'm going to do here on this iteration. I'm going to leave both here on the screen so that you see it. So what that means is the destructuring assignment means that we're kind of like unpacking these values from their array and putting them into the distinct variables, so that when we loop over it, the outcome is as we expect. And this destructuring happens with the square brackets that you can see. Student, score, they're within square brackets. Whenever you see that, you know that that is destructuring. So we're going to do the same console log again. Student and score. There you go. Use a semicolon to close that out. Close out our function, and that's what we actually wanted. Leave us a like if you've learned something new in this video, and I invite you to subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming JavaScript videos.